Hi, I'm Nancy Schick of Third Ear Conflict Resolution. My goal is to keep you out of court and build your conflict resolution skills. And in my last video, I talked about how it's important for us to listen differently and why we would want to do that. And obviously then people did come to the next step, which is, well, okay, you sold me on the idea of listening differently when I'm in conversation with people, but I'm not really sure what to do. And you'll hear me in a lot of my videos talk about listening with your third ear for those hurts that you can heal. And again, that sounds pretty good, right? But what do? It's the same thing with so many of the taglines that we see, the hashtags and everything else, right? And it's like, yeah, Black Lives Matter, totally agree. What do I do? Me too. What do I do? So I'm going to give you three tips today for listening differently, which will change the response that you get and change the conversations that you're having. So the first thing you can do is make the seven choices that I talk about in my book. And that's where you get really connected to where you are in a situation before you engage with another person about it. And this is usually when we're talking about someone who's in, you're in a conflict with, or you're having a heated. Second, you want to listen with the intention to understand and hear something new. You're not looking for proof to prove your case, right? This is not, you know, this is not a trial technique in a basic conversation. I'm a lawyer, so I know trial technique, but that's not what we're doing here. We're not looking for evidence that you're right. And, you know, you've been told that before, that you're not there to just listen for your opportunity to speak. And so in this conversation that we're looking for coming together again and finding common ground, is you need to listen for something new. If you come into it with the intention of making the other person wrong, you're going to make them wrong and you're not going to connect and you're not going to get to any kind of resolution. So third, be willing to walk away. And that's when your emotion gets too high and you recognize you're not listening very well. Be willing to just walk away and say, wow, I'm not handling this as well as I would like. So can we reconvene when I'm in a better headspace? It may be that the other person is the one that's not in a great headspace, but sometimes owning it instead of attacking them and pointing out what they're not ready to see might be a better strategy, right? So it's also being able to step back for yourself or just not win. Because this is not about winning. Discussion isn't about winning. And what does winning really mean in an argument anyway? If your entire relationship breaks down, yay, you won. You won the argument, but you lost the relationship. And that's not really what we're trying to do. So I do coaching on this. If you want that, I do one-on-one coaching. I do group coaching. I'll put the links in the video notes. And in the meantime, do keep listening with your third ear for those hurts you can heal.